Mouni, you am known for selecting such good script. If I talk about gold, about raw, and you're doing Brahmastra. So what is your process of selecting? Is it the instinct or like...
How it's always the instinct and the story, I guess. Okay. So when you read a script, you I always see what first of all, what is the story about? And if it's an interesting story, if I want to be a part of the story, then comes my character and what is this, how is this character relevant to the story? And if I think I have something to do, if the part excites me and if I feel like the role is slightly challenging or it will be an experience, a learning experience. Is that what I mean by that? So then I take it up.
And what attracted you to choose this film?
The story.
What is, okay, that's story.
I remember Robbie sir ne mujhe aadhi kahani sunayi thi, and in that brief half an hour only or an hour, I think, into the narration, I already knew I wanted to be a part of this film, and it would be something that is a very, very interesting story. And it's about a man who gives up everything for his country. He sacrifices his name, his family, his love, everything to kind of... And this film celebrates those nameless people who goes unnoticed and nobody even gets to know the amount of courage and the sacrifice that they've done for the love of their country.
And you said in one of the interviews, like, you'll be able to see multiple layers of my character.
Not so my character, his character. My character, I'm not allowed to talk about.
Okay.
I'm playing the love interest of Romeo. She is a girl, simple girl who works in a bank, and yeah, that's it. I can't say more.
Okay. And John said in one of the interviews, this is going to be like now. This is the time that actors have to do the challenging role. So, do you agree on this? Like, how challenging was for you to do this character?
Well, my challenge was to play like a completely subtle character who doesn't talk. I'm a very talkative person, and most of the roles that, you know, how television is, if you are playing any character, you're giving 10 pages, 20 pages of dialogues, and you kind of, you are, you talk. So, but this one was very subdued. She does most of the talking with her eyes, and so I had to completely follow this Robbie sir's vision and listen to what he was saying very, very intently, and I tried to keep it as organic and as spontaneous as I could because he didn't wanted it to look very rehearsed. So yeah, let's see what's happened now. I haven't seen the film, so I don't
know. You have already worked with such good directors, so coming, like, do you have a list of director do you want to work with?
I don't, if you ask me the list right now, I won't be able to tell you, but yeah, I love a lot of people's work, and the list is endless. There are just so many people, and not just the renowned directors. There are also some extremely new people who are extremely talented and coming up with brilliant scripts, and they have their own vision, and they all add so much more to a story. So yeah, I just hope that I have the opportunity to work with a lot of talented people.
So while you were shooting for this film, you were doing Brahmastra also. So was it
difficult? And I was doing Made in China.
Yeah. So was it difficult for you, see, when you play a character, to come out from that character and to go on another set and to...
No, it wasn't happening like completely, like one day this and tomorrow that.
Yeah.
There were schedules of 10 days, 15 days, and then I would have like a week break and another one would start. So I had enough time to prepare for every and sit with the directors of a particular film, get into the zone, and then start the other one.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wonderful.